Suppose your company has just hired a new intern and you see him struggling with Excel, so let's try to help him out. He's sitting right next to us, and first we see that he wants to find out the country by population, and for that he's going over to the internet, just going to Wikipedia to get the data, and just dragging the whole table and hitting Ctrl C, and then pasting it over here by hitting Ctrl V. The problem is that it all looks quite messy here, so instead we show him a faster way to do it, which first we're gonna go Ctrl Z to go back on, and just go over to the data tab, and we'll go to get data from the web. Here, all we need to do is insert the URL, so in this case, it's this one over here. Just gonna hit Ctrl C, and then paste it down below by hitting Ctrl V, and just hitting on OK. Here in the navigator, we're gonna be able to preview the table that we want. In our case, it's this table 0, which has all of the data alongside the population info, and we're just gonna hit on load. And now you can see that it's going to create a whole table that's nicely formatted into Excel with the population on the side. Next up, we see the intern working on a summary table where you can see right now we have all of this data, and then he's summarizing it over to the side by using formulas like a sum or a sum if. And so he wants to basically paste it in the summary tab. And for that, what he's just doing is simply copying it. So selecting it all, hitting Ctrl C, and then going to the next page and hitting Ctrl V. Now, the problem here is that the data is not linked well, and so he has a lot of errors. Now, one better way to do this is probably by using the camera tool. So we're gonna go over back to data. From here, we're gonna get anywhere within the ribbon and just go to right click and go to customize the ribbon. Once this pop-up shows up, we're gonna go over under popular commands and just hit on all commands. And then we want to hover over to the C area where there's going to be the camera tool. So this one right here. And let's say that we wanna put it in the home page, so in the home ribbon. What we're gonna do is go over to home, just click on that and hit on new group. You can see that we have a new group right there, and we're gonna add the camera. So make sure you have that selected and hit on add. So now we have that camera within the group, and we're just hit on okay. So now you can see that we have the camera here to the side. And so once you have this table kind of highlighted here or selected, just click on that camera tool, and then we'll bring it over to the summary tab and just select anywhere. And you can see that we now have this image, which we can resize and move accordingly. And what's nice is that it's fully dynamic. So if I change a number over here, like let's say under the data, I put a massive number here just so we can see the difference. And you can see that right now it's at this figure, a negative 99 million. So when we go to the summary tab, you can see that that's automatically updated there. Awesome. On the following day, let's suppose that we see him creating a list of 100 numbers. So he's simply using the sequence formula, going to equals sequence and just hitting on 100, which all looks good there. But the problem, he says, is that he needs it to have the ID, so the letters ID, in front of each number. He's not quite sure how to do that, so we teach him a way, which is simply going to be by putting quotations and just putting ID, hitting a space there so we have a separation between the letter and the number, closing the quotations and using the ampersand. That's going to link these two up together, and just hit enter there. And just like that, we have the ID alongside the number all the way to 100. And thank you to Dex for sponsoring this video. If you find yourself struggling to remember and keep in touch with some of your contacts, Dex might be the perfect solution for you. Dex is a personal relationship manager that makes it very easy for you to keep in touch with your friends and colleagues. It combines Facebook, email, LinkedIn, and more to keep all of your contacts in one place. You can easily add more contacts using their browser extension and even give yourself a reminder to reach out to them every month. You can type the message manually, or you can use their new AI feature to create a custom message for you. Another awesome feature is the Dex map view, where you can see exactly who you know in which area of the world, in case you're on a trip looking to meet up with some old friends. So if you're interested in trying out Dex for free, check out the link in the description below. All right, back to the video. Checking in on the intern, and we see that he now has 5 different sheets that he's working on, he needs to reformat all of them. So he's going individually and typing weekly sales, making that bold and also underlining that. And he's doing that one by one. But instead we tell him that, hey, he can actually do it all at once. So all he needs to do is select on all of the sheets that he hasn't formatted just by hitting the control key. From there, let's say we call this weekly sales. We're also gonna bolden it and underline it. And from here, if you go to the to another sheet like product 3, 4, or 5, you can see that all of the sheets now have all of this stuff formatted. Next up, you can see here that the intern is working on a product revenue table and he only wants to have the last 2 years, so 2021 and 2022, but he doesn't want to delete these just in case he needs them later. So he's just going to right click and hitting on hide. Now the problem with that is that if somebody else comes into the model, well, they're gonna think that the data is just wrong because the sum of these two is not going to be 8,000 and it's not very clear that there's some hidden data in here. So we're gonna go back by hitting Ctrl Z first. What we're gonna show him is how to group this. And for this, we're gonna go over to data and then all the way to the side, you'll find the group feature. So just click on that and that's gonna create this collapsible part where it's very easy to tell that, hey, if this is closed, there's obviously some extra data in there. The shortcut to activate or deactivate it is just by going to Alt Shift and hitting the right or the left arrow if you want to open or close it. The following day, we see that he's having to compile share price data for each of these companies. For this, he's got a split screen going on, which seems like a good idea. And he's basically manually inputting each of the share prices and looking them up here in Yahoo Finance. But we think there's an easier way, so we wanna show him, we're just gonna make the Excel file full screen. Just select all of these companies, so Control Shift down. And from here, under the data ribbon, he's just gonna have to go to stock. So just click on that. And it's going to convert all of these into shares. And what it's got right next to it is basically the market where it trades and the ticker, which is the company's trading symbol. So then we just gotta go to this sign over here, to this icon under insert data. What we wanna go for is basically the share price. Click on that. And just like that, it's generated the share price for each of these companies. Next up, he tells us that he needs to assign sizes to each of the orders. So depending on the unit sold, if it's greater than 5,000, then it's a large order, or if it's less than that, it's a small order. So we see him going one by one. So this one would be large, then this one would be small, but a faster way for him to do it is simply by going to use the if statement. So going if, hitting the tab key there, and the logical test is going to be that this figure be less than 5,000. Then if that is true, it's going to be a small. So we need to put it in quotations as it's going to be text there, comma. And then if it's not, then it's going to be a large one because it's greater than the 5,000. Close the quotations and hit enter there. So this first one is large. So that sounds about right. Then we're just gonna double click it to drag it down. This one small, large, and so on. So that's a much faster way for him to go about it. Finally, it's towards the end of his internship, but we still see that he's working on this, where he's trying to find out what the where the revenue is greater than $5,000. And for that, he's created this line chart. So he's trying to predict it here, seeing that, hey, there seem to be a lot over here. So he's probably going to go one by one and try to find which one's above 5,000, maybe change it to bold or something. But we tell him a better way, which is simply by selecting this whole column. So going to Control Shift down. From here, going over to Home. Under Conditional Formatting, we can do a rule where we want to highlight only if it's greater than 5,000. And let's say we put that in a green color. So this one right over here, and just hit on OK. So if we go back up, you can see that we now have all of the ones that are greater than 5,000. But what if he says, hey, I just want to see those. I don't want to see the ones that are less or equal to 5,000. So for that, what we can just do is select any that are highlighted in green, so they're greater than. Then just go to right click under filter. We're just gonna filter by those that are highlighted, so by the cell's color. And now you can see that we filtered only by those that are green, so they're greater than 5,000. We can just remove this chart because we don't quite need it. Another way that we could have gone about this is just by going to this drop down here. Let's clear this filter for now. And instead, we could have done clicking on that, going to number filters, and going for greater than the 5,000. So 5,000 here, and just hitting on OK. And you can see that we get the exact same data as using the conditional formatting.
Wow, thanks so much for your help.
Let me know in the comments if you have any more suggestions for the intern. For more on Excel, to learn about Excel shortcuts to make you more productive, check out this video over here or this link over here to take our Excel course. Hit that like and that subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next one.